I'm Kevin Hart, and this is season 5, and we are back to the locker room. And this is the biggest season yet, which is highly offensive to everybody that was on this show before.
What's up, man?
How are you, man?
What's up, brother?
Mr. Michael Strahan himself. Well, good to see you.
Good to see you, man.
Thank you for coming on, man.
Nice monogram robe.
You like this?
Yeah, I like that.
It's my initials.
I appreciate you putting mine on my robe, man.
Oh, well, you don't get any initials because it's not your show.
It's not my show.
No. Good to see you, though. Come on, man. Let's go. Go over there. Put that robe up. Okay.
All
and
right.
Let's go. Let's get in the tub, man. Thank you, dude, for coming on.
I appreciate you, man. Came ready.
The f*** is going on?
No. We doing an interview, right?
Yeah, well, we about to get in the tub.
Man. I know, but Kevin, I only do interviews in a suit.
Yeah, on your shows. We get in the tub. So unless you want to get your suit wet, go back and get some trunks.
Well, why don't you just put on a suit?
I'm not putting on a suit, Mike. This ain't daytime talk TV.
Come on, man. You know what? I got one for you. Let's go
ahead.
Ain't
this a lot of
shit on, dog?
Ain't this
there
a lot
you go.
Of
we good. Custom made, men's warehouse, my own line, just for you.
I'm mad.
Why?
I'm mad and I'm about to voice my frustration. Who's responsible for this? First of all, is this my size?
Yeah, they gave me your measurement.
Let's start it off with a thank you. Okay? That's what I'll say. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Because the gesture goes a long way. Okay?
Thank you.
Really is a nice gesture alone.
Yeah. Okay? You know, I wanted to do something nice for you, man. You've been working real hard, Kev.
That's true. You know, we don't get that much.
All right, you can wait. You're okay.
We don't get it much, Mike. Come on in, man.
Come on, man.
Mike. What we do is we come around here, right?
Okay.
We sit on the back of the tub,
okay.
Talk a little bit, then we get in the tub further, okay? Oh, there we go.
You know how long this has been getting in the ice tub? I haven't been in the ice tub in 14 years for a reason.
Well, I want to start off by saying, welcome, world.
Hey, world.
Welcome to all new episode of Coldest Balls. I, of course, am your host, Kevin Hart. And today I am with a Hall of Famer, a legend. I'm talking about the man, the myth, Michael Strahan.
Who is cold as balls right now.
Yeah.
Not even gotten
cold,
in this
right?
thing.
Yeah, it's pretty cold. It's stupid. Mike, I want to start off by saying thank you for coming on the show.
Kevin, thank you.
Your greatness on the field is unmatched. You know, your numbers speak for themselves. Your achievements under the New York Giants umbrella.
I feel like something's coming.
No, I'm giving you flowers first. I trash you.
Because you're a Philly fan, so I know something's coming.
I'm going to trash you at the end. Not now, though. You somehow managed to transfer the same energy on a football field to TV. I got to say to you, kudos. This is a new thing
Thank
I'm
you.
Trying to do. Now that that's out the way, that horse now we can get to the real interview. White hand, take this, please. Thank you, man. It's time to pay some bills. I'm sorry.
Do it.
White hand, please. Okay. This episode of Coldest Balls is brought to you by Fiji Body Wash, which is forged with real ingredients. Did we get that, guys, when I do this? Did we get it? Good.
Can I smell it?
No. Here you go, white hand. Thank you. Okay. Are you having more fun as a TV personality than you did on the field?
Different type of fun.
Different type of fun.
It's different.
Mm-hmm.
It's like one of them, the fun was literally... like beating up on people.
Okay.
That was fun. Walking out in the stadium, 80,000 people screaming your name. You know how that
feels.
Well, you
play for the Giants. I don't think it was ever 80.
Yes, 85. Wow. Just like when you go to your concerts, man. Yeah. I've been to your shows.
Yeah.
You got 3,000 people in there.
No,
you know, when
not,
they give away the free tickets and stuff,
numbers,
you know, to get people
correct.
In there, like $3,000.
That number's not correct.
But walking out there, man, you feel like a gladiator.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you literally feel like a gladiator. I don't get that same sense when I'm walking on the set with Jordan and Robin at GMA or
okay.
one of the Fox guys. You get it's kind of just the old football players now who realize we can't do it anymore.
Mm-hmm.
We can talk about other guys who can.
I feel like going into the entertainment, going into the daytime talk.
It's different, though.
But you've...
It's like you going into football. Probably a little bit... Well, it's not a good comparison.
I don't. Why would tell me why would you say that? What I think it's a
because
very
it's because one like me going into TV and like it's realistic.
So you've seen no footage, is what you're saying?
I've seen no footage.
Well, then that's the problem, guys. Can we pull up my church league footage for Mike?
Church league.
There's a clip of me taking Pastor Nelson's head off when he tried to come down the middle when I was the middle linebacker, and you're gonna take those.
You were middle linebacker.
Middle linebacker at the age 12. I was the same height, same weight. And I was a monster. All right, so going back to you now and the place that you are, right? When you talk about the younger generation of football players, when you look at these contracts that are being given out today, when you look at the money attached to these contracts in the game today, what is the feeling? Talk to me about it.
My reaction?
Yeah.
Damn. I might feel like Florida Evans, you know? But I don't get mad, though. These young cats, they deserve it.
Yes.
Because if somebody writing you that check, imagine what they're making.
Yes.
But the change has been incredible. It's been a bigger change than I expected.
Fast.
It's been fast.
It seems like
because back
as
in the day,
left.
Kev, I was the highest paid defensive player in the league for about 6-7 years.
Yes.
But I don't get upset about it. I'm glad about the evolution of the game. My only thing is I just hope that these players don't squander it.
I think that's the information that's most important. And actually, that's the information that's not given enough.
We need to have all these financial seminars, and they tell guys that these are the different steps. And
but what who's telling them, Mike?
These financial people and these other people try to help you.
If I'm young football star,
okay,
you tell me, young football star, don't go be a star today.
We're going to do this and deduct this and put it in your 1A, 2A. And the money opportunities come from a lot of...
That's how you're going to say it?
Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear that. I want to hear the guys that know my life get my attention because they've been where I've been.
We should do it.
Honestly, I don't have the time.
How you going to throw it out there and you don't want to participate?
Here's why. We'll cut this out. Them guys. What I'm saying to you, we'll cut what I just said out. Why? Give me that. Give me that. Hey. I'll edit this in. Here, Mike, smell the Fiji body wash. It's forged with real ingredients.
Smells delicious.
Here, my hand. See, I cut that, put that there. We'll never
know. Okay, can I stop for a second? Yeah. My calves are absolutely, I can't feel them.
Yeah.
So we can't, we might as well go.
Let's get deeper in the tub. We got to. Hey, we got to do that. Let's go. Here we go. Come on now.
Who came up with the idea of this show, man? No. You got to do it too. I ain't going to do it by myself.
You think I'm going to sit up here and let you do it by yourself? Is that why you're here? No, you're here because we are doing an interview. There you
go. Woo! Woo!
All right.
Woo!
So, let's now go to the second
piece. I'm taking right now. You better get your ass in that tub.
I am in the tub. You don't think I'm in the tub, Mike?
I swear, I know, Kev. I get out this tub.
You don't think I'm in the tub?
If I get out this tub,
okay.
You ain't going to like it.
Here we go.
Get in the tub.
Oh, here we go.
What the hell is this dude doing?
Oh, that's Bam. Hey, Bam. Oh, there's Daryl. Here we go. Oh, no shtick today, huh? You guys didn't want to come out in anything?
Oh, y'all crazy, geez. Man.
All right, guys.
I appreciate that love.
Okay, that's enough.
That's love.
All right.
Kev. They look good. Don't you think they look good?
You proud of yourself? You're going to be a big f***ing star, you know that? You're going to be a real big star. All right.
I'm proud of them.
Let's get to the deeper side of the conversation. By the way, such a good interview. I knew it would be, too.
Well, it'd be better if you get your in the tub.
I'm going to get in the tub. You don't know what I'm dealing with.
Well, what are you dealing with that's keeping you from getting in the tub?
Mike, have you ever heard of cold tub dysphoria?
If I have, I don't care.
Okay.
They got nothing to do with
you. It's what I have. And it's a real condition.
What's wrong with you, man?
All right.
Get in the tub.
I am, man.
Come on. You got it. You can do it.
I hurt my knee.
Okay. This will help.
Let's talk about the football league today. Let's talk about the competitive side of it, right?
Mm.
I think the league is a lot more athletic than what it once was. This is not a shot. It's not a shot. Please listen to the rest of it before you go into old-timer rage.
Who's the greatest linebacker in the history of the NFL, in your opinion? You know who it is.
Reggie White.
He's the defensive end. Who's the best linebacker? You know he played in New York. His number was 56.
Lawrence
he had
Taylor.
Two of Lawrence Taylor.
Yeah.
Thank you. And you said Reggie White. You're not naming a modern player, Kev.
I know that. I just want to throw a nod to the Philadelphia Eagles. But
You know what? Nod to the Eagles. All right, Eagles, I appreciate you. Eagles fans, I appreciate you. I appreciate beating the hell out of y'all.
Okay.
Every time I had a chance.
All right.
More sacks against the Eagles than any other team in the history of the NFL in my career.
Yeah.
Thank you, Donovan McNabb.
Wow.
Good luck in the future.
Extremely immature what you're doing.
So there we go. That's how I feel about the Eagles.
Extremely immature what you're doing. Because you're messing around. It's time to get all the way in.
Go be harder for you because I'm already frozen.
No, no, no.
I don't have
you
much more to go.
Take the stool out now. It's time to go. It's time to get active up in here.
All right. There we go, white hand.
Got it?
Good job there, buddy.
All right. Time to take it to the next level. So, Mike, here's what I want to know. I want to know, are you still a Giants fan? Like right now, I know you played there, and I know that's where your heart lies. But let's just cut to the chase. What a organization. I mean, when you really talk about the bottom of the barrel, you talk about a team that just can't seem to get it right, from ownership to talent that they bring in. It's just a f***ed up pot of s***. Do you still love this organization, Mike?
Yeah, I'm still a Giants fan.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How do you feel about your season this year? You guys feel like you got a shot?
We suck, Cam. We suck. Right now, we suck. What can I say? It's heartbreaking every Sunday. I got to sit there in that studio. Yeah. I got to help guys give me a hard time. Yeah. And I got to sit there and have my heart ripped out because we find a way to lose games.
All right.
Get in
all
the
right.
water, by the way. You can ask
me. Get your grubby hands off of me. All right, I'm in.
What are you doing that way?
All right. Get off of me, you pervert. You freaking get your freaking ass up out of here. Lord knows where your hands been. I heard about what you do on Thursdays. Get out of here, Bam. All right, enough with the gaps.
Yeah.
Get out of here. And what in the mock turtleneck t-shirt is that, Daryl? How many shirts you got on? He's got on 5-1. That's a turtleneck, a t-shirt, and a tank top.
It don't matter because the smiles are beautiful.
Jesus Christ.
Smiles are beautiful.
All right.
Thank you, fellas.
What organization do you feel like has it right?
So I'm not giving up on my Giants, but realistically right now, I would say, of course, Tampa. You know, you Tom Brady.
That's where I'm going next.
Bro. Yeah, I mean, you got Tampa. You got Brady, 44 years old, playing like he's 20-something. Because he's one of these guys. If you say he can't do it, he probably, like, holds the clip.
Yeah.
And keeps watching it back and forth to motivate himself. Me, you say I can't do it. So you might be right.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe.
Going home. Okay. Time.
Well.
Ain't going to waste no more time with it then. I'm going to move on.
You nailed that one. I couldn't do it.
I had a coach. And this is a bad analogy, okay. But this, you know, back in early 90s.
Well,
you know,
70s.
He used to always say...
75 when you played.
90s to 2007. Let's not push that. Okay. Not lies. You know, I'm a young man.
62.
Sitting in these cold tubs, this is taking me back to my days. I mean, I meant to get ahead and hit somebody or something, man. Well, but this got you back.
Daryl, you're dressed in equipment today. You want to let Mike get a little shot at you?
That's not who I had in mind.
Well, he's got the neck brace on. Why don't we, Daryl, you want to take a little shot today? See if you still got it? All right, maybe not. All right, Mike, we're going to wrap this up with a little game. That's how I'm ending things in my new season. I do a game with my guests.
And what's this game called?
Well, this game, we're going to throw it back. We're going to play a little football. Little old school football. Okay. Table football.
I haven't played this since I was a kid, man.
I bet no kid in this generation even knows what this is. You probably don't even know what this is. You don't even know the importance and value in this thing here.
This built families.
Right here. Brothers. Right here.
This caused more fights between brothers than anything else in the house.
Facts. Shouts out to my brother, Robert Hart. I used to f*** you up. So, Mike, here's what we're doing, okay? First one, to get it through, right? Okay?
Can I say something real quick?
What's that?
I'm slightly offended by this game.
Why is that?
Because I'm looking at these goalposts and I think you're making fun of my teeth.
Well, I didn't notice that till you said it. Now that you said it, I am. Yeah, now that you said it, I'll take that. Guys, good job. I did that on purpose. All right, Mike, are you ready?
Yeah, let's go. Who's going first?
Well, it's my show, so I'm going first.
That's rude. The guest should be first, but that was not too bad.
Nope, that's... Just like a New York Giant, off the goalpost.
Slightly right. Oh, wide right, like Scott Norwood. That's how the Giants won the Super Bowl in 86.
Maybe it's because your fingers look like feet. Okay, here we go.
Maybe because I've actually done manual labor.
Yeah, well, that's what you call it. I don't. That's it. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
That didn't go in.
Thank you for an all-new episode of Coldest Balls. I'm Kevin Hart. I've been your host. As usual, I do what I do, which is win the games, take the guns, and put them in the holster. Bang, bang. That's right. Give them that ice.
Give them the ice,
Daryl. Bam. Give them a look at the last gap he'll ever see, because this man is what I call a loser. I'm Kevin Hart.
Why you gotta do it like that?
Well, because this is the gap. I'm Kevin Hart, and this is Cold as Balls. Thank you. I'll see you next time. Will we have a better guest? Of course.
When? Who? Ain't nobody better than me.
Did you see that? I'm undefeated.
No, you're not.
I haven't lost yet.
Yeah,
Mike, every game we play, I literally win. Ooh. Every single one. Wow, man. Such a good day. Kevin Hart, the game crusher. Hey, Mike, do you have my number?
Yeah, I got it, because I know if I say no, you're going to say something
smart. Well, no, I was going to make sure you do, so I got good reason to change it, because I don't want to talk to you.
Well, come in. Don't forget your suit.